There are more than 7 billion people on planet Earth. Over 8 million of them live in one of the biggest and most diverse places in the world, New York City. Although New York City contains thousands of cultures, religions, and lifestyles, there is a constant pressure to conform and blend in with the crowd. As humans, we all have unique personalities and characteristics that separate us from others. So why do we wear masks to hide them? Whether it's hiding behind a fake persona, behind some type of a screen, or behind a physical disguise, we're all concealing something. What's your mask? So, in New York or generally in the world, do you feel like people are hiding their true selves to protect themselves or impress other people?
Do I think it's true? Yes, it is true.
I think that's true.
100%. 100%. Definitely.
Without doubt.
People do not necessarily expose their true personas.
I'd say in general, it's probably like the natural human instinct, you know, to probably hide your identity.
Almost as a means of self-protection.
Our sister, Brianna, used to be a big tomboy, and one day someone asked her to show them her penis, which she obviously doesn't have, and so she started toning it down a bit because people were making fun of her and calling her a man and stuff.
Different parts of you come out when you're with different people?
You know, it's just different masks you have to wear, different identities you have to assume to fit in different circles.
With my family and friends or just by myself, I have more of a weird personality where I like to show off inner parts of me that don't usually come out in the business world.
And so certain elements of who I am or what I'm into, I can't bring necessarily just anywhere I go.
Your identity is really based in performance.
No one wants to commit a social taboo.
You don't really have that freedom to be yourself, I don't think.
I think that people using their phone all the time is kind of like them putting up this social barrier.
You want people to think that you're constantly communicating with other people.
I think they don't hide their personalities. I think they might hide their emotions.
And is there a way to make people feel more comfortable in public so they can behave the way they want to behave without feeling uncomfortable or anxious or insecure?
I would say just kind of change advertisements, because I feel like everywhere we go, you're told how to dress, how to act.
I think if these social standards weren't preset for us, we would probably have more lenient ways of acting.
I feel like most of the time, fashion is determined by your friend group, and so I feel at the same time it could be improved to the point where people just like who their friends are and they hang out with them regardless of what they're doing or how much money they make or what they wear.
Apathetic is like cool, and I think if we kind of broke that down and made caring something that is cool and something that is like a desirable trait in a person, then people would be much less likely to like be on their phones all the time or would be more willing to like smile at someone or like talk to a stranger.
The more we focus on the fact that people are judged, the more we focus on the fact that people are treated differently, the more they're going to get treated differently.
Like, we're starting a movement where people are accepting, then that movement itself is like, be different, but be different this way.
If there wasn't such a movement towards like needing to fit into a stereotype that we see on social media or like in our friend groups or at work or in family, and people could just be what they want to be, then that would be like a great thing. But that just comes with like cultural acceptance in general. It's not really like a something that one person can do. It's just like a movement that the world has to go through.
How many roads must a man walk down before you call him a man? How many seas must the white dove sail before she sleeps in the sand? Yes, and how many times must the cannonballs fly before they're forever banned? The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind.